upcoming temptation as you grow up, you have to get married, correct? You have to choose your life partner. How do you choose your life partner? Again, the answer comes powerfully through another Bible chapter in the book of Genesis, that is Genesis chapter 24. Genesis chapter 24. Genesis chapter 24. Now, in this chapter, so many questions that you are asking about your marriage is answered. What are the questions that we ask? One question is, whom should I marry? The answer from that chapter is, marry a believer. If you read verses 2, 3 and 4 of Genesis 24, Abraham told his servants, he was the oldest in his household. He was in charge of all that Abraham had. He said, put your hand under my thigh and make me swear that you will go to my country and find a life partner for my son. He said, keep your hand on my thigh and promise. Why? Those days when somebody places a hand on the thigh and promises, it means very serious promise. Why? Because Isaac could not marry the Canaanites. Who are the Canaanites? They were unbelievers. So Isaac had to, Abraham's servant had to travel. And some Bible scholars say he had to travel 21 days till he went and met a believer girl from a believing family. Young people, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 39, speaking about whom you can marry, the Bible says you can marry anyone but in the Lord. You marry anyone but in the
Lord.
To start my ministry among youth called G4 mission, grabbing the Google generation from G4, from Gehenna mission, G4 mission. I worked in a call center. I raised my money first, and then of course God later led many people to support our ministry. But initially I worked in the call center and raised the money. So when I was working in the call center, I would talk to American customers and I would collect dollars from them for their car payment. So when I called them, some people would use abusive language, use filthy language and say, why are you calling me? And they will use all the filthy language.
Call center re loko manku ahwan kali je mo ei jo ministry arambh koruchi au ei ministry re mote tume sahajya kara boli ki au se bideshiya loko mane se mane mote kahile kharab bhasha re mondo bhasha re gali kori ki tume au kahile je tume kahi ki eha kariba pai jaucho.
And when that happened, we had a rule in the office. We cannot scold these customers back.
आउ कस्टमर मानको अमाने गाली गुलाज करके पठाई दे पाए
इवन इफ वी टॉक्स अबाउट आवर मदर एंड सिस्टर इन द वर्स्ट पॉसिबल वे वी कैन नॉट स्कोल्ड बैक नेवर वी कैन डू दैट
आउ से भी नियम अछि जे कस्टमर मानको बापा मा कहि कि से मानको बुझि न पड़ो किंतु से मानको गाली गुलाज करके पठाई देबार विषय में
इफ वी डिड दैट The manager will come and remove our badge and send us out of the job immediately. So, scolding back the customer is non-negotiable behavior. In the same way, you know, God says you marry anyone. 1 Corinthians 7:39. You can marry anyone. That really means anyone. But in the Lord, the only thing you can't compromise is as a believer, you must marry another believer. No compromises on that.
आओ ईश्वर से पहुँचने प्रथम कर्म के साथ प्रवाहे तुम्हें जहाँ कोई विवाह करी पाएगा पहुँचने किंतु शेठी बोले विषय लोग चंदे जे विश्वासी को अविश्वासी को बाहर का विषय से पहुँचना भी तुम्हें केवल विश्वासी सामने बाहर का विषय से पहुँचने
But you say, well, I will convert this girl, I will convert this boy after I marry that boy. You say.
नहीं पाए तुम्हारे कहीं पाए वो जब मुझे को विवाह ना करे परिवर्तन करे देगी बस जब विवाह ना करे परिवर्तन करे नहीं करेगी एक बार कहीं पाए वो
That's what the wisest man Solomon thought. The wisest man. People came to listen to him from all over the world, taking the flight, taking the cab, taking the ship, all over the world. People came to listen to his wisdom, and he married unbelievers. But what happened? Solomon. What happened to Solomon?
Yani Solomon, jeki sundar sundar kotha gyanar kotha kohutile boli ki desh bidesh ro lokmane tango gyanar kotha suniya pai hasile sei Solomon se kon kale obishwas manko madaru anek stri manku se bibaha kore.
The women he married made him worshippers of idols. Nehemiah 13:26. I believe if you read the Nehemiah, if you read his story in 1 Kings, you know, the book of 1 Kings, you know, Solomon worshipped idols like his wives he married. He became an idol worshipper.
विदेशीय स्त्री मान को बाहर करते सेम विदेशीय स्त्री माने जो देवता मान को पूजा आराधना करते सोलोमन मध्य तांको सहित से प्रकार से पूजा करते
दैट्स व्हाई यंग पीपल
सेटिफाई युवा युवती माने
द वन यू टेक टू बेड विल इन्फ्लुएंस योर हेड विल चेंज योर हेड वन यू टेक टू बेड विल चेंज योर हेड सो बी केयरफुल होम यू मैरी
आओ तुम्हें कहां से विवाह करने पर मनोमन करो अति
So that's the first question answered. We ask the question, whom should I marry? Genesis 24 says, marry a believer. That's why Eliezer had to travel 21 days to find a believer for Isaac. Now we have second question now. There are many believers in this world. How will I know which believer to marry? Even that question Genesis 24 answers. There are three words to use, to remember, to find out which believer you have to marry.
ओ विश्वासी को हमें विवाह करिवा को हेबो सेटा तीनो विषय हमें मन रखियो को
फर्स्ट वर्ड इज सप्लिकेशन और प्रेयर
आ प्रथम विषय होची प्रार्थना रे हमनकर विषय को प्रभु पठाए समर्पण करिवा
एंड ही सेज इन वर्स 12 ऑफ जेनेसिस 24 गॉड ऑफ माय मास्टर अब्राहम प्लीज grant me success today what is success in finding a life partner for my master's son God of Israel, please grant me success. He prayed about it. He said, God, lead me to the right girl. So you pray for a right partner. You pray.
मते जुगाओ तुम्हें मत जनाओ बोली से प्रार्थना कले प्रार्थना रे निजर निवेदन प्रभु को ठरे माने रखिबा
एंड इन जेनेसिस 24 एंड वर्स 63 टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ दैट चैप्टर 24 एंड वर्स 63 आइज़क यू नो व्हाट वाज ही डूइंग द बाइबल सेज ही वेंट टू द फील्ड्स And he was meditating. What was he doing? Went to the fields and meditating. Maybe he was praying. Lord, uncle has gone. Uncle Eliezer has gone to find a good life partner for me. Show him the right girl. Show him the right girl. I want to marry the your will for me. I want to marry the girl you have in mind for me. Not anyone else. Isaac went to the field meditating. Maybe he was praying for his life partner. So that's the first thing. What is the first thing you tell me? Prayer.
Prarthana.
Or supplication. Second, use your sense, use your head. You know the story, it's a Sunday school story. You know, he said, I will go to this well and these girls will come. The girl will not only give me water, but also give the my camel's water. That will be the girl.
मते पानी देव आवल मत नुह मोर पशु मानू देव से ही से झील हम बोली से मनरे भाभी
सो व्हाट इज द एप्लीकेशन हाउ डू यू अप्लाई इन योर लाइफ
आउ तुम जीवन रे ए विषय को तुम्हें किमिति भाबरे प्रयोग करछ
शुड यू प्रे लॉर्ड इन माय कॉलेज टुमारो द गर्ल वेयरिंग द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ अ येलो सलवार एंड पर्पल सलवार येलो एंड पर्पल इफ वन द गर्ल Who wear the first girl to wear a yellow purple color salwar? She will be my wife. Is that how you should pray? No. Use your sense.
निजर बुद्धि ज्ञान को खर्च करो.
What is he trying to do here? He is trying to find a girl who is generous, the girl who is giving, because a girl who is generous and a girl who is giving, and maybe the first person you meet like that will be a very good life partner for you.
I say, if you pray for the Jyoti, Udara, Jyoti, Dhanushya, Jyoti. माने समर्पित हाँ बोल कह
I've been married for 15 years. I got married in 2001. I've been married for 15 years. And marriage has taught me one lesson. When I went to Bible college, my teacher, Dr. Jacob Chirin, already told me, but that time I was not married, I didn't understand. But you know, said, marriage will reveal how selfish you are. These 15 years, you know, God is treating me through my wife to remove all the selfishness from my life. Because marriage is all about being unselfish. Young people, the moment you think of marriage, you think of sex. Sex is part of marriage. It's a small part of marriage. Marriage is all about unlearning your selfishness and becoming more selfless as you relate with your wife and as you relate with your God-given children.
Mm-hmm.
You It's removing your selfishness from your life. It's not about sex. It's not about sex. Is just a small part. That's why Eliezer saw this girl. She's giving me water, and my camels, they drink bucket and bucket and buckets of water, but she doesn't mind bending her back and pulling the water out of the well and pouring it and putting the bucket again and pulling the water out of the well. Though my camels drink bucket and bucket of water, this girl unselfishly gives drink not only to me but also to my camels. So this unselfish girl make a good wife. That is the logic, that is the sense here. Young people, that is why don't get carried away by external appearance. This ball is so tall as Amitabh Bachchan. You know, this girl is so good looking. Her skin is as smooth as Hemamalini's skin, as Lalu Prasad Yadav often says in his speeches. You know, and that's, he said, I'll make Bihar's road like, you know, Bihar's roads like Lalu Hemamalini's skin. You know, that's how Lalu Prasad Yadav said. Okay, this girl has got such a smooth skin. Okay, this boy is as tall as handsome. These are good things, but don't get carried away. Look for beauty which tape cannot measure. That is humility. That is liberality. That is a nature to give. These things tape cannot measure. So first prayer, second use your head sense, and thirdly seniors, consult with the seniors in your world, your parents and your pastor and spiritual leaders. Consult with them as you finalize the life partner. You know how the story goes? From the well, they go to the house. Eliezer and this girl go to the house and she consults with her parents. She talks with her brother and finally they ask her, are you ready to go with this man? She says yes, and then Rebecca joins Eliezer and goes towards, you know, that long journey to Abraham's house. In the year 1999, in my summer vacation, when I was in first year Bible college, after first year in Bible college, I came to do ministry in Orissa. You know, I've preached in several places, Berhampur, and you know, so many different towns I preached that one entire month. And that was an unforgettable summer for me in 1999. And I preached in a few churches in Umarkot, and many of those churches were established by a missionary uncle called Ponnusamy from Tamil Nadu. He came to Umarkot and he started at least, I remember, 40 churches, and I went with him preaching in these churches with Uncle Ponnusamy from Tamil Nadu, a missionary.
Missionary
We were talking about many things, and suddenly the topic went to a girl called Evangeline. And you know, Uncle Punasamy said, "You know Evangeline? You know, Mr. Selvam's daughter, Evangeline. Okay, she is. She came here. She also came here for vacation. She came to this church. She preached. She preached a powerful message, and she was saying, he was sharing so many good things about this girl called Evangeline, Mr. Selvam's daughter." I already had seen this Evangeline in a youth camp some years ago, and what this missionary, senior missionary, said about Evangeline, I joined it all together. I went to the jungles of SABC and prayed, and then the Holy Spirit led me clearly to marry Evangeline. That is how I chose my life partner, after prayer, after using my sense. Because this girl, I knew from another conversation, before she met me, before she knew I existed, in her school, she committed for full-time ministry. So I know I'm going for full-time ministry, and this girl is also committed for full-time ministry. And these are some good words of testimony that she has among the senior missionaries. All of it came together from a world of many believers. I found out, this is one girl I want to marry. I want to live with her for the rest of my life. So these are the three words to remember when you choose your life partner from the world of many believers: prayer, supplication, sense, and seniors. And when you combine both together, God will lead you to the life partner. And then one final question I'm going to ask, and I'm going to finish this Bible study from Genesis 24. Yes, I must marry a believer. Okay, I know how to find among the believers which girl to marry. And now I found a believer, but we have few months to marry. And we are now talking with each other. Is it okay to touch each other intimately? Before marriage, is it okay to touch each other intimately? That's a question a lot of young people are asking. You read Genesis 24, 64 and 65. Rebecca goes with Eliezer, and there, far away, Isaac also sees her, and he gets up, and he gets up to and rises to meet her. Rebecca says, "Who's that young man?" And Eliezer says, "That is Isaac, the man you're going to marry. That is Isaac." And the Bible says in Genesis 24 and verse 65, she covered her face with a veil. It is symbolic of the restraint when it comes to physical intimacy that she wants to have with Isaac before marriage. She saw him, this is a guy I must marry. She put a veil, which means she wants to maintain a physical distance with a boy before marriage. That is a symbolic of the veil in front. It is symbolic. You read Ezekiel 23. Young people, read Ezekiel 23, the full chapter. The Bible talks about Ohala and Ohaliba there, two young women. Ohala and Ohaliba.
Ohala and Ohaliba. These are the three.
The Bible is very frank. They allowed men to play with their breasts. The Bible is very frank. So I'm frank. And the God calls it that act as prostitution, as adultery. God calls that act as adultery. Touching each other intimately before marriage as adultery. They didn't have sex. They did not have sex. But they did everything else. That is a sin against
God.
They touched each other in places they should not be touching each other. That is a sin against God. That is the message of Ezekiel 23. That is what we learned from Rebecca, who put a veil when she saw Isaac. The moment she knew she was going to marry him, she put a veil. Symbolic of the physical distance, safe distance. You must hold yourself back before you marry your life partner. Would you close your eyes? All eyes closed. All heads bowed. How many of you here would listen right now in God's presence? I will only marry a believer. Raise your hand. I'll only marry a believer. Raise your hands. Raise it high. I will wait till God brings a godly believer into my life. I want you to make another decision. I will not give my body away cheaply to my boyfriend or girlfriend before marriage. I will hold my body holy. Would you place your hand over your heart? Hand over your heart to say, I will keep my body pure. I want you to open your eyes now. And go to the back page of your Bible right now as we finish. Go to your back page of your Bible. And take a pen. And I wanted you to write out a promise to God right now. And this is the promise. I have said it in English and it will get translated. From this day onwards, I will say no to all forms of premarital sex with the Holy Spirit helping me. From this day onwards, I will say no to all forms of premarital sex, premarital physical sex with the Holy Spirit helping me. And you sign your name. Write down your commitment to Jesus right now. Write down in your Bible, write down at the back page, write down with the help of the Holy Spirit. From this day onwards, I will say no to all forms of physical sex. Till the day of my marriage. And sign your name. And after you sign your name, Give your Bible to your neighbor. And your neighbor also will sign on the other side. What is that? Witness signature.